Geh drei, deutsche Sturmgewehr. It's deutsche Präzision, German precision. Couple rounds, let's get started. In today's video, we have two rifles that we're going to evaluate. We have a DSArms Sa58, 18-inch, and a PTR G3 clone, also an 18-inch. Both rifles spawn M-lock handguard, a front grip, a flashlight, a sling. Both have the same LPVO in it. Both have a Picatinny rail. So the playing field is even. There's no platform has an advantage over the other one. So yeah. Also important in this video is that I'm not going to tell you which platform is better than the other one. That's up to you to figure out. All I'm going to show you is a few impressions that I got on running these rifles and a few things that you might want or not need on your platform. At the end of the day, you can go buy whatever you want. This is also an accuracy testing. There have been numerous videos out there testing the accuracy of the PTR or of the DSArms. So I'm not going to go into that. I don't have time for it. This is solely a short comparison between these two rifles. We're gonna look at three major categories. We're gonna look at reliability, user-friendliness, and aftermarket products. So let's get started. In terms of user-friendliness, we got three categories that we're gonna look at. The first one is the safety, the second one is the mag release, and the third one is the charging handle. The first thing we're gonna look at is the safety. On the FAL, the safety is a non-ambidextrous safety and is comfortably placed to be reached by the thumb of the right hand. On the G3, however, the safety is placed on a kind of like an awkward spot, still like close to the thumb, but it's more difficult to reach. And especially if I want to put this rifle from fire back to safe. The next thing we're gonna look at is the mag release. On the FAL, we have an ambidextrous mag release. It's easy to grip with the thumb to release the mag and put it back in there. It's a big ambidextrous mag release. On the G3, we have two styles of mag releases. We have a button on the side, which is almost impossible to reach, even if you have regular sized hands. Or we have a paddle as well at the bottom, which is smaller than the FAL ones and is slightly harder to get to. Even if you hit the button on the side, you still have to rip out the mag with your non-dominant hand. The last thing we're going to look at is a charging handle. On the FAL, we have a charging handle that is comfortably placed closer to the shooter, and it's closer to grab and to charge, or whereas on the G3, the charging handle is placed way forward, and it's more difficult to grip and to rack it. That concludes this testing on the user-friendliness of these rifles. On the reliability part, we do have a big advantage of the G3. The G3 just eats any ammo that we run it through. In today's videos, we ran it through a different variety of ammo, hunting loads, regular 150 grain, full metal jacket, military style like M80 ammo, and it just ran fine. On the FAL, we have a gas system that we can adjust to each type of ammo that we're shooting, and in our, or my opinion, it is a more finicky system.
Boo!
It does work, but it is, let's say, you have to set it or dial it in to a specific type of ammo that you want to shoot to ensure that it runs reliability. It's like one of the drawbacks on the FAL. But apart from that, the FAL did great with every type of ammo that we threw at it. We just had to use the gas system and adjust it. The last part that we look at is the aftermarket products. On the FAL, we have more aftermarket parts available. We have DSArms dust covers. We have M-lock rails, there are Picatinny rails available as well from a different manufacturer. Even DSArms made a big rail for the FAL. There are different mag releases that you can install. There are different charging handles that we can install on the other side as well. We can convert a fixed stock FAL to a para FAL. We can even throw the modern battle-ready stock from DSArms on it. So there are numerous things that we can swap on FAL. So that's a huge advantage of the FAL rifle. For aftermarket products, the G3 has a disadvantage. There are not many things available for it. You can get an M-Lock handguard, as this one made by Midwest Industries, and you might get a scope rail attachment that clamps on the top of the receiver, and you get cheap mags. But as you can see in these pictures, the mags can dent easily. And that's about it. Maybe like a different muzzle brake. But yeah, so you're very limited what you can get. You can't get a folding stock or whatever, a collapsible stock on it. There's like one company that makes different kind of stock for them, but the most of them are fixed. And because the spring extends into the stock. So yeah, on a G3, you're very limited with aftermarket products. So overall speaking, you have an FAL, you have a G3. They're both good weapon systems. They're both platforms that I run with that I do like. However, there are certain drawbacks and advantages of each platform. So at the end of the day, it's up to you to figure out which platform you prefer and which platform you want to run with. This video was just intended to give you an overview and give you kind of an idea what certain platform or what each platform does better over the other one or what the platform has. This is not a sales pitch to tell you need to buy product X or product Y. It is up to you to make up your mind. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video.
The slide.
I'm sweating.
The slides.